set a good example for all of us. Jean-Marie Vianney died in 1859, universally known as the curator of arms. Compassionate spiritual counselor who spent no less than 11 hours a day in the confessional during the wintertime and 16 hours a day in the summer, patron of priests and of parish clergy. Now I know I don't spend anywhere near that amount of time in a week, but reconciliation is important, and he was dealing with a community that was really, really known for its drunken behavior and immoral activity, so he reinforced the whole idea that we need to reconcile. So that's a good thing for all of us to reflect on. As we pray together in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We've gathered to celebrate our faith and give glory to God. Let us take a moment and acknowledge our sins and ask for forgiveness. I confess,
Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of all the angels and saints, and even my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The following message came to Jeremiah from the Lord. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, write all the words I have spoken to you in a book. For thus says the Lord, incurable is your wound, grievous your bruise. There is none to plead your cause, no remedy for your running sore, no healing for you. All your lovers have forgotten you. They do not seek you. I instruct you as an enemy would strike, punish you cruelly. Why cry out over your wound? Your pain is without relief. Because of your great guilt, your numerous sins, I have done this to you. Thus says the Lord, see, I will restore the tents of Jacob. His dwellings I will pity. City shall be rebuilt upon hill, and palace restored as it was. From them will resound songs of praise and laughter of happy men. I will make them not few, but many. They will not be tiny, for I will glorify them. His sons shall be as of old, his assembly before me shall stand firm. I will punish all his oppressors. His leaders shall be one of his own, and his rulers shall come from his kin. When I summon him, he shall approach me. How else should one take the deadly risk of approaching me, says the Lord? You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. When the Lord has rebuilt Zion and appeared in his glory, when he has regarded the prayer of the destitute and not despised the prayer.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
groaning of the prisoners, to release those doomed to die.
The Lord will build up Zion again and appear in all his glory.
The children of your servants shall abide, and their posterity shall continue in your presence, that the name of the Lord may be declared on Zion and his praise in Jerusalem. When the peoples gather together and the kingdoms to serve the Lord.
The Lord will build up Zion again and the year of all for his glory.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him on the other side of the sea while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the water. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And he said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water towards Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out to the Lord, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him. And he said to him, "Oh, you of little faith. You, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." After making the crossing, they came to land at Gennesaret. When the men of that place recognized him, they sent word to all the surrounding country. People brought to him all who were sick and begged him that they might touch only the tassel of his cloak, and as many as touched it were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So with so many of you here, I gotta do a question and answer home. See if you got the right answer. But I won't do that. Then I'd have to walk around and check on you, and that would be not good. So, in the gospel, particularly today, we hear of three ways to pray that are common, that are the tradition of we who are Catholics and Christians following the Jewish tradition. Three ways that prayer is revealed in the gospel. The first one is after Jesus has dismissed the crowd, he goes off to the mountain to pray. Think about it. There are four kinds of prayer. There's prayer of contemplation, prayer of petition, prayer of thanksgiving, and prayer of praise. So when Jesus went off to the mountain to pray, what kind of prayer was he practicing? Contemplation. He was in communion with the Father, spending time and just recognizing and acknowledging the Father, and he was contemplating the will of the Father. So Jesus himself gives us a clear example of a way to pray. Sit in communion with the Father. Give the Father your time and attention. Make that a part of your daily life. Then the disciples are out on the boat, and they're being tossed about, and Jesus walks towards them. And what's the next kind of prayer that we hear? Petition. Lord, save me. And we're very, very familiar with that, aren't we? Whenever there's a difficulty, whenever there's a trial, whenever there's a misunderstanding or an inability to understand, we go, Lord, help me, Lord, help me, Lord, help me, Lord, give me this, Lord, give me that, Lord, take this away from me. We are very familiar with the prayer of petition. And that's what the disciples did in the boat. In their chaos, in their fear, in their not understanding that there's a figure coming towards them, they don't recognize it as Jesus, they're being tossed about, they think that the angel of death might be coming. Oh my Lord, save us. So prayer petition. The disciples give the example to us. And then Jesus comes in and he calms the sea and he says to Peter, come walk on the water with me, come to me. You think you can do this? Come and do so. And of course the failure takes place because he loses his focus on Jesus. He starts to sink and get back in the boat and all the other disciples. And then the disciples share the next kind of prayer. You know what that one is, don't you? Praise. No doubt you are the Son of God. Scripture gives us good examples all the time of how we are to live and how we are to pray. People say they pray, and I know all of you do because you're here doing that. But so many people, and many Catholics, if you ask them the question, do you pray? Yeah. How do you pray? Well, I can't verbalize it. How do you pray? There's contemplation, there's petition, there's praise, and thanksgiving. What we are doing here in the Holy Eucharist is the prayer of thanksgiving. As a community, we're saying, thank you, Lord, for sending your Son and for the gift of forgiveness. Thank you, Lord, for opening the gates of heaven to the promise of the kingdom that we all long for and desire, that is our goal. Those of us who know these things are called not to just know them and practice them. That is important. But also called to invite others to pray. Grandparents, do you ever ask your grandchildren, how do you pray? I don't know, Grandma, I don't know how to pray. Well, let's talk about that. Let's teach them. Parents, same thing. Who is Jesus for you? How do you communicate with him? I'm watching the video series called The Chosen, which is the life of Jesus. And it's a powerful vision, and the one scene talks about Jesus and the children, and these children come to him, and he keeps asking them wonderful questions, and expects from them a response from Scripture or their tradition. And I thought, man, as a pastor, I probably ought to do that. Children, tell me one of the Ten Commandments. That's the fears that they might say. But we want to affirm them, encourage them, develop them. And that's all of our responsibility. Not just the priest, not just the religious education director of a parish. Particularly it's the responsibility of the parents to say, I will raise my children in the ways of faith. And maybe one of the basic aspects of faith is to teach your children how to pray. But it's important for us to know what prayer is and the aspects of prayer. So today in the Gospel, three of the forms of prayer are revealed: contemplation, petition, and praise. And in the midst of hearing this Gospel, we are in this Eucharistic celebration, which is the prayer of thanksgiving. It's all inclusive, and it's here. Let us then stand and offer our prayers of petition to God, asking God to respond to our needs. That we may continue to grow and develop our own religious background and understanding, grow and develop our ability to communicate with you, our God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Bishop Joseph and all the trusteers will be open to and follow the guidance of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government officials around the world, that they may see their role and responsibility as the care of the common good and the nurturing of their people and the world, universal humanity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who have died, that they know the fullness of the kingdom of heaven, and that those who are grieving may be consoled, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the many people who have asked us to pray for them, to petition on their behalf, that our discipline of prayer may be a source of support for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle with diseases such as cancer, that God's grace may guide the doctors and the nurses and the scientists who strive to relieve humanity of this nemesis, and that if it possible, many people will be healed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parents, as they strive to live their example and their promise of teaching their children in the ways of faith, practicing their religion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our children, that they may seize the opportunities to learn and to grow, whether it's in school or in home, that they may be open to the gifts of knowledge and understanding, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and all-powerful God, we have voiced many needs. We hold many more in our hearts. We ask you to hear them all and grant them all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread that we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine that we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Please pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of your name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down the Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he blessed. broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink of this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis I, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and with all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Vianney, with St. Leo, our patron, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, we now have the courage and the confidence to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Safely share with one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Holy Communion, John will be here. We'll start with the sisters, and then this section, and then this section. And John will take communion to Bert when the time comes. And I'll go on this side. We'll start with this section, and then this section. For those of you who are at home or those who cannot receive Holy Communion, let us pray the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul.
Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen. Let us pray.
too, Father.
Heavenly Father, bless our diocese with the grace of many vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life. Through the intercession of the Blessed Mother, grant to those who are called the willingness and generosity of spirit, giving themselves and devoting their lives and their talents to the service of our Lord and to His Church. Increase the faith of all within our diocese, and especially the faith of those you are calling. We ask this through Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.